Women to Women on BCTV is supported by Women to Women.
Good morning and welcome. My name is Karen Marsdale, and I'm on staff at the Greater Reading Chamber of Commerce and Industry that founded our organization, Women to Women. Welcome to Women Live. Today, I have with me Bethany Kirkner, who is Director of Events at the Chamber of Commerce and is very involved with Women to Women. So our discussion today is going to be about something coming up on April the 26th that we are very much looking forward to, and that is our Spring Expo, our Women's Expo called Spring Renewal. And this is our fifth year. Bethany and I were just talking about this. This is our fifth year of bringing this program to the community, to the community of women in Berks County. And it's a great day. It's full of workshops and keynote speakers and opportunities for networking. And it really came about with the help of Penn State. This is a new name for Penn State, for St. Joseph's.
Penn State Health St. Joseph's.
I'm so used to saying St. Joseph's Hospital. But they came to us 5 years ago, and they were really anxious to do something through Women to Women that could meet the needs of women from a health perspective, and thought that it could be a good idea to kind of blend something that would be not only educational, but educational on a lot of levels, with women's health being, you know, obviously a primary a concern for St. Joe's at the time. And so we got together and we came up with this idea of spring and renewal, and, you know, it's time for all of us to kind of take a step back. And so we looked at this from a perspective of our bodies, our minds, and our spirit, our soul. So we take a look at all three aspects of us as humans, as women, and we look at our workshops and even our keynote speakers and the themes that we want to present around those three themes. So we've done that successfully now, going into the fifth year, and each year it seems to grow. I think last year we had over 330 women attend. And I want to say first and foremost to the audience that Women to Women is an organization. It is sponsored by the Chamber of Commerce, but it's open to all women in Berks County. It's not necessary to be a member of the Chamber. There is no fee to join Women to Women. There are fees for varying events like the Expo. But we do have a litany of sponsors, too numerous to mention in this context this morning. But the reality is the sponsors have come on board because they support and they want to partner with women and grow the organization and help women have access to the kinds of programming and events and seminars that we do throughout the course of the year. So, you know, we invite all of you to take advantage of being part of the day of the expo, the 26th of April. So let's, Bethany, talk a little bit about what the day is going to look like, because you've been very involved, right? Mm-hmm. You know, in the weeds, working on this with our council and with our committee of great women who come up with some amazing ideas for workshops and topics, etc. So. Let's talk first about, I'm particularly excited this year with our launch keynote speaker for breakfast, Dr. Linda Wayman from Strawberry Mansion High School. So let's talk a little bit about her, because we've been waiting for her a full year visit Berks County.
We'd wanted her last year and couldn't get her, so we are just so excited to have her. I mean, this is a great story. From Strawberry Mansion High School outside of Philadelphia, which was considered one of the most dangerous high schools in the United States. And Dr. Wyman couldn't find a principal to hire.
Right, she was actually assistant superintendent, one of many assistant superintendents in Philly.
So she actually took on both roles herself. and
as a woman would do,
right, to get it done and turn the school around, and just wants to see those kids succeed and take them out of those dangerous circumstances.
Right.
And she was featured. Diane Sawyer followed her, mm-hmm. And her steps through her tenure there, through her school year as the principal, to see what strides she made, and it's amazing how right. much she did in just 1 year. And so she's now done some TED Talks. She's been on Nightline. Lot of requests for her to speak.
So. Lots of requests for her to speak. She last year, when we first connected with her, she was so thrilled and humbled to be asked to come back to Berks County. As a matter of fact, she's a Kutztown grad, so she's coming back home.
I didn't know that. That's
yes,
right.
Yes, she's a Kutztown grad, so she was very thrilled. But she was going to L.A. for a TED Talk, and so she just, you know, and in the middle of all this, she's still the principal of Strawberry Mansion High School.
Right.
So she's really gotten on the radar screen and doing a lot of speaking engagements, and I've not heard her speak. I would suggest for the audience, just Google Strawberry Mansion High School, and you'll get to Linda Wayman, and just get snippets of a YouTube video of her speaking, and she is so passionate about her students,
yeah.
and that's really has
she's
been
she's raised
huge.
Their test scores, and for the first time ever, they've been taken off the list as a persistently dangerous school,
which is great.
Which
I mean,
is
that's
wonderful.
I think that's, you know, just her perseverance, her passion, her abilities, her obviously her strengths. As an educator, we're anxious to hear that story because mm-hmm. we know that the youth of our community, just like it is around the country, is the future of our world. Mm-hmm. And without having that good solid foundation in high school, and so many of these children, as we see here, you know, in our community, in many school districts, they need that other family, if you will.
And to feel safe.
And to feel safe.
Right.
And to feel safe.
So feel safe.
So she's got a great story. Please Google her and then make plans to be with us for the day on the 26th. So we're very excited about that.
And what's interesting for our viewers know, while we want you to join us for the whole day, you don't have
Good
to.
Good point. Good point.
If you're just interested in coming to see Dr. Wyman, you can register for the breakfast-only keynote
Absolutely.
Speaker. So you can just see her and then go on with your work day, or, you know, if you have other things on your schedule. So while the expo is certainly a great all-day-long experience,
right,
you can just come to see Dr. Wayman. Which
right.
is
that we've tried to make it very convenient for women who are in, you know, many different environments, whether they have to get back to work, kids, whatever the case might be. So good point. You can come for a part of the day, all of the day. It really doesn't matter.
Mm-hmm.
So after Principal Wayman is speaking that morning, we've got a great lineup of workshops. And, you know, as we talk through our workshops, one of the things we always are looking at Women to Women is going back to our mission, which is very simply to grow more women leaders in our community in Berks County. And we won't go into detail today, since we're talking about the expo, of how we do that in other programming and events and seminars and peer groups and leadership learning, etc. But I think the workshops, I'm especially excited this year with some of the topics that we've come up with, because we've, you know, I hate to use the term out of the box, but I think we've thought out of the box mm-hmm. a bit, and just how we can always keep things fresh and new and sort of on the cutting edge of what people are thinking about. We do a lot of surveying of our members. What do they want to hear? And I think we've reflected that in the workshops. So
I think what's great too about our workshops is that we're pulling from local speakers,
absolutely,
women that live and work right here in our area. It's not, we don't pay these speakers, you know, we don't fly them in.
Sure.
But they're women right here that are experts and can talk about their experiences. So I think with our programming committee, we have a great group of women that from all sorts of different industries and different backgrounds, and then we say, who knows somebody that could talk about this.
And that's the power of what we do in connecting the dots, I think, in so many ways. But you're absolutely right. These are real live women who don't come down from a pedestal and come in to talk about, you know, these issues. They're living these kinds of things every single day. They may be experts in a field, of course, when it comes to many of the subjects that we'll discuss. But you're right. It's really it's real,
mm-hmm.
And that's what's I think. That's what's why it's has the impact that it does, I think.
Mm-hmm. In our first section of breakout sessions, we have, as you mentioned, we have three tracks, body, mind, and soul. So you can mix it up. You don't have to follow soul all day or mind all day,
right.
Body all day. You can say, well, I like the title and the speaker on that one and mix and match throughout the day. But talking about some of the tracks in our body track, we have Dr. Schenkel from Penn State Health St. Joseph talking about anxiety and what is your body telling you. So from a clinical standpoint, mm-hmm. what is that constant headache or backache or heart
palpitation?
What does it mean?
Sure.
And is it anxiety? And what methods can you use? Do you just need to do some deep breathing or is this more serious mm-hmm. and you need to listen to what your body is telling you? So I think, especially women, we put a lot on our plate.
Absolutely, absolutely. And then we start to really get the headache, we get the backache,
right.
Our muscles are tense in our back when we go for a massage, and we wonder why.
Right,
because
exactly.
It's the chronic anxiety,
mm-hmm.
and so many other diseases and chronic diseases are caused by this being in and the anxiety moment continually,
mm-hmm.
And just living there, and then other things start to happen. So I think that's going to be a great
topic. That was a topic that came up a lot
mm-hmm.
with women.
Going back to the surveying,
right.
Absolutely.
I deal with this? And you get to the point where you're such in a constant state of anxiety that you don't even realize it until you go on vacation.
Right.
We're looking forward to that. She's a doctor, so her clinical, what are we really doing to ourselves?
From that perspective, I think that's very important.
Right. And then in the next body session, sort of a little bit different topic, all women love, how do we stay looking young?
Oh, please, absolutely.
It's
the billion-dollar industry that it is.
Sexy Skin Through the Ages, a holistic approach. And this is great. This is a panel that's going to be speaking, looking at it from a dietitian's point of view, how we can keep our skin healthy.
Sure. What we put into the body reflects on the skin.
Someone from Reading Dermatology, from a clinical standpoint, what do we need to do to take care of our skin? And then also from a more of a spa aspect, we have Flavia DiPaola, who's an esthetician, makeup artist at Bell Tower Salon. So the three of them are going to bounce off one another and talk about in your 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s and up, and then also from each of these three areas.
Right, right. I think that one's going to be very, very popular as well, because we all, we live in a society that, the fountain of youth we need to find somewhere,
right.
Because, that's the threshold that we're all trying to get to. And yet we need to be really, really paying attention to our health is so much a part of how our skin.
Well, skin cancer.
So exactly.
It's not just about the wrinkles and looking young, but it's also.
Right, about the numbers of people every year diagnosed with skin cancer. And, it's a big issue. And I know with Amy Hendricks, who is a physician's assistant, I believe.
Right.
At Reading Dermatology, it's very concerned, and I had a conversation with her, and she really wants to, I think it's become much more of an awareness factor in our nation today, but I still think we need to be very astute about what we're doing with our skin when it comes to
the sun. I wouldn't be surprised if the women that choose to attend this session are shocked by some of the statistics. Yes. And it might be a wake-up call, too.
Yes, right.
You know, I'm going to my son's baseball game, and I'm not
wearing sunscreen. Exactly. I'm gardening, and I'm not.
Right.
Well, moving along, I think we're about 10 minutes into our show, and we've got lots more to talk about. So how about we flip to the mind?
The mind. Well, this is really interesting because it's a topic that certainly not all, but a lot of women feel uncomfortable talking about, and it's money. So,
for sure.
So we have, again, a panel that's going to be looking at how we deal with money and the changes in our life. Did you get a new job? Are you caring for an aging parent? Divorce or married? These all affect your money, but it's not just the money, how much do I have? But they're going to be looking at the emotional impact of money.
I love that.
Right. And because when you go through these transitions, it affects you, it affects your spouse, your family. So the panel's going to be talking about how to best handle your finances, your taxes, and your legal issues, as well as the emotional issues. You know, are you fighting with your significant other about money all the time?
Absolutely. I think that, you know, one of the, I guess, top five reasons for divorce are financial issues. Mm-hmm. And so often in our surveys, women really do feel that they don't know enough about financials from a standpoint of being able to effectively create budgets. How am I going to effectively start saving for my children's education? So I think this is a way to kind of start to talk about, and we've had other sessions on those types of things, but I think this is great looking at it from almost the emotional side of money.
Right. And so this panel is made up of an accountant, an investment advisor, a licensed professional counselor, really focusing on the emotional impact of money, and then a CPA from the tax standpoint. So
sure.
They're all going
to
be
what a eclectic group of people to talk
right.
about money
right.
from a licensed psychologist or
right.
counselor all the way to and the others that would be sort of a little more what you think more typical, but really hitting that emotional side I think is going to be
right.
going to be great. So,
and then we also have in the mind track getting back in the game. We have two professional women who took time off for various reasons. One, a stay-at-home mom for many years. What does it take, the courage, what are the first mm-hmm. steps to get back into the workforce, or flip it around and say, I don't enjoy what I'm doing, I'm going to totally reinvent myself, how do I even go about doing that? So these two women are going to talk about how they got back in the game of life, of career, after being at home or not working for a period of time.
You know, I think this is another one of those topics that really comes up so often, whether, again, I go back to the surveys that we conduct or just in conversation with women. And I think today, more than ever, we're given more choices and opportunities, and it's less of a factor that you're kind of stuck in a mold that you created for yourself when you were in your 20s, perhaps. That women are doing things that are totally outside of the area, perhaps that they studied in college or worked in for many years, and feeling almost the sense of freedom and relief that they're mm-hmm. they're suddenly doing something that's they're following their passion. We talk a lot about that, and they're successful. They're mm-hmm. successful at it.
Right.
So I think it's great to do these explorations, if you will, through these kinds of workshops.
Right. And our last in the mind track is, are you fully engaged? Which is coming up a lot lately. You hear mm-hmm. it on talk shows about being present in the moment.
Mm-hmm.
So Kim Rivera, the executive director of Girls on the Run, Berks County, is going to be talking about being in that moment. Are you guilty of racing from one thing to another? not really engaging when you're there because you're thinking about 10 million other things. And so she's going to talk about how to fully engage your own life and be better equipped to manage your day-to-day life. And
I'm looking forward to hearing this because knowing Kim well, and she's just a woman who's done amazing things in the short time that I've known her, 5 years. I met her, I think, on the very first launch of Women to Women, and talked of her dream of starting a chapter of Girls on the Run here in Berks County. And I think this topic is really relevant now, more so than ever, because we, as women, there's an expectation of wearing so many hats, and sometimes we gloss through every one of those and think to ourselves, what did I really do yesterday that was impactful or important?
Right.
Or, you know, how long has it been, if you're a mom with younger children, that you've spent real time, you know, one-on-one with your children? So many ways to look at that. And I think this is going to be a really engaging conversation.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Well, the other thing, you know, I don't want to try to remember everything in a short period of time of what the expo looks like, but you know, it's a great time to network. Women, there's so much energy at the Crown Plaza when we convene this this event. Women are great networkers. They love to be in the company of other women, and that's exactly what you'll get from this day. We've got dozens of vendors, women-owned businesses that'll be there in a lot of different areas of business, from retail shops,
right,
to salons and spas and...
Well, you have the typical sort of what you would think of as a women's expo with the salons and the spas and the different products for women like cosmetics, but then you also have... women-owned financial companies.
Absolutely.
That, you know, maybe you're more comfortable talking to a woman about how to invest.
Right.
We have Manor Golf Course talking, mm-hmm, about women learning how to golf.
Right.
And women-only clinics, if that's the setting that you feel more comfortable in.
Right. But which we have. We're running one of those, I think, coming up this spring or
in June. In right.
June.
Even Penske, who's a sponsor, investor in Women to Women, and Schneider Electric as well. You don't think of them as typical, like, well, why would they be at a women's expo? But they are there to talk about HR recruitment. You know, these are the positions and types of jobs that we're looking for, women, intelligent, capable women to come on board.
Absolutely. Both of those companies are very progressive. Feel very strongly about promoting, hiring and promoting women within the organization. They know the value of that. So there's something for everybody, I think, that day. And again, if you, one of the most important things we didn't say was, if you want to register and come on board for any part of this day, you can just log on to our website, which is www.greaterreadingchamber.org, or you can even call us directly and register by phone, 610-376-6766. It's on your screen right now. But we really would encourage you, take time for yourself. You deserve it. You've earned it. And see us on the 26th. We look forward to seeing a lot of women, and we're going to have a great day. And Bethany, anything more you want to say to the audience?
Well, I think you need to look at it as an investment in yourself.
Absolutely.
You know,
absolutely.
Whether you just come to the keynote speaker in the morning for $20, or you invest the $60 in yourself, come for the entire day. You have three different breakout sessions. You have two keynote speakers. We'll be honoring an amazing woman with our Athena Award. She's the Athenian.
Right, right.
And then we're capping it all off with a wonderful fashion show.
Completely forgot. We have a great fashion show end of the afternoon presented by Boscovs, who is another investor in Women to Women. And that's going to be a lot of fun. So there's something for everybody. Love to see you come out. Have a great day. And we'll see you on the 26th of April.
Women on BCTV is supported by Women to Women.